This is the third episode of the Tanzania Safari series, and this time we visit Lake Manyara, described by Ernest Hemingway as the most beautiful I've seen in Africa. Lake Manyara is home to flamingos, tree climbing lions, and lots of water birds. Let's go on safari with us one more time. The shallow Lake Manyara is an alkaline lake and hosts huge flocks of pelicans and pink flamingos. The shores of the lake attract more than 400 species of birds, many of them waterfowl or migrants. Large herds of buffalo, impala, Maasai giraffe, and zebras roam the lake shores and the forested valley slopes. The common impala is a medium-sized antelope found in eastern and southern Africa. The male's slender, lyre-shaped horns measure 45 to 92 centimeters in length. The horns of this male are probably deformed by a lack of vitamins or inbreeding. Only the males have horns. Bachelor herds tend to be small, with less than 30 members. The natal coat of a fowl of the plain zebra is brown and white, and the brown darkens with age. The zebra's dazzling stripes makes them among the most recognizable mammals. They have been featured in art and stories in Africa and beyond. They have been associated with beauty and grace. Some wildlife photographers describe them as the most photogenic animal. Fully grown Maasai giraffes stand 4 to 6 meters tall. Males weigh 1200 kilos and females just above 800 kilos. The coat pattern has been claimed to serve as camouflage in the light and shade patterns of savanna woodlands. Both sexes have prominent horn-like structures called ossicones. Also, a median lump, which is more prominent in males, emerges at the front of the skull. Male giraffes become darker as they age. Giraffes often rest while standing up. When lying down, they fold their legs under their body, but mostly keep their necks held high. Oxpeckers feeding on ticks. Yellow-billed stork feed patiently by walking through the water with partially open bills and probe the water for prey. Contact of the bill with a prey item is followed by a rapid snap bill reflex, whereby the bird raises its head and swallows the prey whole. This is the forward fret, with the tail at a 45 degree angle and all feathers erect. Juveniles and young adults of the leopard tortoise are attractively marked with black blotches, spots or even dashes and stripes on a yellow background. Majimoto Kupwa Hot Springs. A large swampy area on the western shores of Lake Manyara, through which flow several hot springs that seep from the nearby Rift Valley wall. Bubbling at over 60 degrees Celsius, they are hot enough to pass the boil and egg test. The common name blue wildebeest refers to the conspicuous silvery blue sheen of the coat. Dutch settlers first discovered wildebeest in about 1700. Due to their resemblance to wild cattle, they called them wild ox or wild beast. This is the subspecies Eastern white-bearded wildebeest. This olive baboon has been caught doing what? No, I'm just eating some leaves here. One major reason for its widespread success is that the olive baboon is omnivorous and will eat practically anything. The diet typically includes a large variety of plants and invertebrates and small mammals as well as birds. Grooming reduces tension by lowering the heart rate and releasing endorphins that are calming, healthy, as well as reinforce social structures and bonds. They are also called the Anubis baboon, after the Egyptian god Anubis, who was often represented by a dog head resembling the dog-like muzzle of the baboon. Also because of the four-legged gait, baboons can appear very canine-like. Their rumps are bare, because they sit squarely on it. It has no nerve endings and forms a permanent cushion for the baboon. The hamakop normally feeds alone or in pairs. Amphibians and fish form the larger part of its diet. The usual method of hunting is to walk in shallow water looking for prey. The great egret is a large heron with all white plumage. elephants eat dirt to provide the minerals, salt and calcium they lack in their diet. It helps them digest their food by breaking the material they eat into smaller pieces, which ultimately leads to more refined digestion and absorption of nutrients. There is no question who has right of way when an elephant crosses the road. The vervet monkey eats a primarily herbivorous diet, living mostly on wild fruits, flowers, leaves, seeds and seed pods. In agricultural areas, vervets become problem animals as they raid bean, pea, vegetable, fruit and grain crops. The males are larger in weight and body length and may be recognized by a turquoise blue scrotum. The grey-crowned cranes spend their entire day looking for food. They're omnivores, eating plants, seed, grain, insects, frogs, worms, snakes and small fish. The southern ground hornbill is the largest species of hornbill worldwide. They are carnivorous and feed on insects, snakes, other birds, amphibians and even tortoises. They live in groups of 5 to 10 individuals. The hornbill is characterized by black coloration and vivid red patches of bare skin on the face and throat. A juvenile bird with pale facial skin. We came across this leopard as a parting gift. Both sexes use urine to mark their territories. Often after urinating, a male will then scrape the ground to transfer the scent of his urine onto his feet to be carried during territorial boundary patrols. We didn't see any tree-climbing lions, although the park does promote itself as the place for it. We saw them later in this series, so keep watching. Next week we will move on to the Ngorongoro crater, where we only just escaped being eaten by lions. If you like this video, subscribe to our channel and watch the next video.
Dream,
explore,
and travel with us.